There are new weather warnings across southeast Queensland, with several creeks and rivers breaking their banks. It comes as the system which swamped north Queensland during the week brings rain in a massive band stretching right along the east coast of the country. Brisbane is expecting at least as much as 70 millimetres today, with severe storms and flash flooding expected.
Evolving rainfall situation, and we're certainly not out of the woods yet.
Overnight, the main street of Killarney in the Southern Downs region was swamped by a flash flood, with several businesses inundated. To the election now, where Scott Morrison is announcing the government will get even tougher with foreign criminals, forcing them to pay the costs of their own immigration detention before they're kicked out of the country. The government claims the move would save taxpayers about $216 million a year. Labor will focus on the Great Barrier Reef, boosting coral protection programs with funding of almost $200 million. And this, of course, comes just days after the release of a report warning of a coral bleaching disaster. A mother accused of brutally killing her own two-year-old daughter while in a cult west of Sydney 35 years ago will face court today. Ellen Craig was extradited from New Zealand yesterday to face a murder charge. Police claim she beat her daughter Tilly to death with a plastic tube. The cult leader, who was arrested last year, is accused of trying to cover up the crime by disposing of her daughter's body. Police are investigating a vicious home invasion overnight in Toongabi in Western Sydney. It's believed a man in his 50s was hit over the head with a gun by intruders, as well as being kicked and punched before being either jumping or being pushed out of a second story window. Now, the man has multiple injuries, including possible fractures, and he's now being treated in hospital. Residents in Southern California have been forced to flee for their lives, with a large wildfire destroying more than 20 homes. 100 houses were evacuated and at least 80 hectares of land scorched by the blaze in Orange County. Firefighters say it ripped up steep ridges propelled by windy, tinder-dry conditions.
Our fuel moistures right now are very low, which basically means that when a fire starts, it'll get established very rapidly. Throwing some wind on that and the terrain, the steepness of it, was a bad recipe.
It's one of dozens of wildfires burning across the country. The biggest of them is in New Mexico, where at least 170 homes have been destroyed in a blaze that's been burning now since the start of April. Russia is threatening retaliation as neighbouring country Finland begins moves to join NATO. Russia's foreign ministry says such a move would seriously damage bilateral relations with the country, as well as the security and stability of Northern Europe. Finland's president and prime minister have called for NATO membership without delay in response to Russia's invasion of Ukraine. It's set to formally announce its decision on Sunday. In an extraordinary feat, scientists at NASA have managed to capture the first images of a huge black hole at the centre of our galaxy. The black hole, known as Sagittarius A, is about 27,000 light years from our sun in the Milky Way, so we won't be sucked up into it anytime soon. Until now, all knowledge of it was based on the indirect measurements of stars looping around the galactic centre.
Look at that image, and that hole in the center has 4 million solar masses. That's incredible. And there was doubt for black holes for decades after they were first derived as a mathematical solution. Everyone kind of assumed that they just evaporate once we understood more.
Absolutely breathtaking. And here's some more mind-boggling facts about the black hole. It has a radius of 6 million kilometres, and it would take 240 million years for the Milky Way to make one complete lap around it. Holy moly. Let's take a look at the weather for your Friday. And as mentioned, the entire East Coast is being battered by rain today. But our hearts and support go out to the people in southeast Queensland. That's where it's being hit the hardest. Flash flooding. We're expecting up to 70 millimetres of rain today in Sydney alone. People expected to evacuate their homes. Sydney, you're also receiving rain, 22. Rain in Canberra as well. We've got rain coming our way in Melbourne also, 22 for Adelaide. Rain for Perth also, and a top of 33 in Darwin.